Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Humbled Mumbles back at you with another Eminem music video. So far, he has been 2 for 2 for me on his videos. We've listened to his first two albums on the track. We've listened to Premonition, and we have also listened to Unaccommodating. I really liked Premonition. I liked the intro. I liked how he came. I liked the intro of his last two albums. I liked the way he did that. I like those kind of intros. Unaccommodating, I wasn't feeling young MA's verse. She just didn't do it for me. But Eminem came and saved the track, in my opinion. And it's got to be tough for these young artists to be on a track with Eminem, because the dude is just a lyrical genius. That's all you can really say about it, is the dude is a genius. So we've got You're Gonna Learn. This is featuring Royce da 5'9 and White Gold. Never heard of White Gold. I know Royce da 5'9. I like Caterpillar. They got one called Caterpillar on Royce's album, and I liked it a lot. They got another one, and I can't think of the name of it off the top of my head, but I like him. I don't know a lot about Royce, and I haven't heard all his stuff like I have with Eminem, but I did like him on that track. So I'm kind of hoping that, you know, carries over to this one. So let's check it out. Let's see what we got here.
Out of that poverty, profiting off of copping and swapping that property out for a possible monopoly. Trying not to adopt my father's old philosophies. Same time, I'm praying to God that everything works out at his colonoscopy. I'm walking across a suicidal tightrope intentionally. While the demons coming out of me, wifey's on the side of me talking sense into me.
So is this White Gold? This must be White Gold. And so far, I like his flow. I like the sound of his voice too. You know, some people just have voices that are just out of this world. You know, people like, you know, let's just say Lil Wayne, for instance. He just has that distinct voice, you know. And then I can always tell you when Andre 3000's on the track, or Eminem, you know, or 50 and all that. So he's got a nice voice. His flow so far is okay. It seems like it's a little in and out, but this is good. And I'm going to have to listen to this again later to really get what they're saying, because, you know, things fly over our heads all the time the first time we hear it, and then you go and read the comments like, oh, you missed this bar, and it's like, yeah, you're right, I did. So far so good. I mean, it doesn't sound like Royce da 5'9 to me. I think this is that new guy that I've never heard of. He might not be new to you, but he's new to me.
Life is on the side of me talking sense into me. Without she, I feel incomplete mentally. She's been sent to me right there since 9-6. Worst nightmare to side chick. Some things are just meant to be. This it for me, give my daughters a kiss for me. Y'all call this fame, I call this shit alcoholistic infamy. Targeting my kids and babies through population and gun control. Shit make me wanna make 100 more, make a bigot racist uncomfortable. If y'all against talking reparation, then I'm not against the thought of separation. Why the politicians and the white and privilege act highs is different from segregation. That's funny, bro. Segregation is being told where I'm gonna go. Separation is being woke and going wherever I wanna go.
That's nice, he said some nice things there. I was trying to look him up, White Gold. You know, I typed in White Gold, I typed in rapper, and all I got was White Gold, like the song by a whole different rapper. So I'll find this guy, White Gold In My Ways. Oh, is this him right here? So maybe White Gold, maybe I typed it wrong. No, there's a space there. There's absolutely a space in between his name. So there we go. I'll listen to more of his stuff later. I'll try to find out who this guy is. White Gold rapper bio. Let's see. I mean, is this guy who used to be called Little White? Is this the same person? You know, there's a maybe it is. Who knows? You know, maybe it is. But that was nice. He said a lot of stuff, and I liked his verse much better than I liked Young M.A.'s verse. I did, and I definitely need to go back and listen to it again. Let's check out what the rest of the song has to offer.
Spoken, going wherever I want to go.
See the mall, little boy, you gon' learn. I really like the little beat change there when it comes out with the snare and the cymbals and, I like that. It just takes me back to my days when we were in band and we would always try to add extra. Like every time we were doing a song, this was in middle school. Every time we try to do a song, we always add a little extra like bass notes in it to give it a little bit of a cooler feel. And we would always get a look from the conductor. He would look at us. The teacher would look at us like, what are y'all doing? Stop, just to spice it up. It was fun. Never sold dope, full of gold rope. Wanted one though, they were so dope. Was a have not, cause my pockets didn't have knots. I was so broke. On my last rock, for my slingshot, better haul ass. Don't be no slow poke. Through the tall grass, run your ass off. Oh no, got your pants caught on the fence post, getting chased. By them jack boys, think it's about the floors like a lint roll. Let it wait till it's late, they will tiptoe through your living room window. Take a Nintendo and then skate, making you feel like you got bent over and raped. Little boy, you're never gonna get no rope chain. Get your shit stolen, your lips swole. I became bitter as I got a little bit older. My hate was making me get colder. Began to get a chip shoulder, started to spit vulgar. This is like one of his, this is just one of his normal type flows. This is one of his, you hear this in a lot of his songs. And again, I need to say, he is one of the few masters that can take a sentence and rhyme in the middle of it and stop and finish it, and give you that pause. He has that pause for the effect of the rhyme. And then he continues the sentence to add on to the next, line. And it's really cool. Let's see if we can find that. Let's see. Came bitter as I got a little bit older. My hate was making me get colder. Began to get a chip shoulder. Started to spit vogue. My zip code had been skid row. But I ate every single beat that I spit over. The shithole I escaped. Then I began to explode, detonate. Now the east side went schizo. Thought my name was B-side because they flipped over my tape. And I won't hesitate to get them all bent so out of shape. Shit, vogue, hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape. And I'm not gonna let her treat the paper like I'm chopping. I'll let her dress how you wash red. Y'all remember that video, the Superman video with, with the big dude? Oh, it was so funny. Oh, man. What was the name? The boy band song? Oh my gosh, I'm totally going blank. What was the name of the group? The group was funny. They would put out some funny music. Oh my gosh, why am I going so Eminem rap group? What was it called? D12. There it is. Okay, I couldn't think of it. D12. Oh man, they put out some funny songs, man. Oh gosh, they put out some funny stuff. I mean, I know they didn't go very far, and the whole thing with them, leaving them, and like he talked about in his last album. But they put out some really funny stuff. They did. Let's go back a little bit, and I'm weird, guys. I'm weird with like everything's got to be like zeros or fives. Whenever I restart a video, it's got to be at 0, 5. It's just weird. Like increments of fives, it's weird. Hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape. And I'm not gonna let her treat the paper like I'm chopping. I'll let her dress how you wash red. So when you refer to the guy next to the document shredder, now the cops wanna set up roadblocks on my header. Got several bounties from feds in every county. I'm with a gal at a checkers wilding, bumping fuck the police while I'm fed her rallies. This shit is like romper room. Why do I feel responsible for these kids? All of whom I'm a father to. I'm a god to you. Y'all better worship the water. I walk on it. Y'all gonna meet your Waterloo. I get the flipping. The mic is a murder weapon. I'm popping an extra clip and cop and shoot. Then I'm popping. Do not let me catch you slipping. I will pop up and I'll take a spot from you. Dang. Oh, I'm talking about following all these little kids. Talking about the bright, right? Is he talking about his fans? Listen, and the way this song is ending, maybe that was Royce da 5'9" rapping, and maybe White Gold is singing the hook. I don't know. But it didn't sound like the Royce da 5'9" that I've heard on Caterpillar. And I can't think of the other song that I heard him on. So I don't know. Not really sure. But I like what he just said right there, talking about all these kids, worshiping the ground he walks on when he walks on water. And his play on words is just so amazing. So amazing. I've said it a bunch of times. I mean, most people who listen to him say that. It's just, he's amazing. This shit is like rubber room. Why do I feel responsible for these kids? All of whom I'm a father to. I'm a god to you. Y'all better worship the water. I walk on it. Y'all gonna meet your Waterloo. I get the flipping. The mic is a murder weapon. I'm popping an extra clip and cop and shoot. Then I'm popping. Do not let me catch you slipping. I will pop up and I'll take a spot from you. I get to doing what a leaky faucet do. But I ain't talking drip when I say that I'll give the drop on you. Singing fuck all of you in auto-tune. I am too volatile and too grisly to bear. Yeah, shit is getting to wear. I can barely even sit in a chair. I bust my ass for this shit and I swear. It ain't even worth dissing someone so offbeat that they can't even figure out where their words should hit the kick and the snare. Tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. All them pretty bitches leave your ass in the What I've noticed too with this album, it seems like the music is going right to the end and it's jumping right to the next song with a gunshot or with something. And it's really nice flow. You know, if you're listening to it, you don't have this long pause in between your tracks. And that's really something that's really cool. And now I'm really, really wanting to know who did that first verse, because it didn't sound like Royce da 5'9 to me. But I could be totally wrong. And after I'm done with this video, I'm going to go listen to Caterpillar again. That just did not sound like him to me. Another thing I like, I've noticed as Eminem's career has grown, his verses get longer. He's giving us so much stuff. He's got so much that he wants to put in his verse, and he's not dumbing it down for anybody. You know, he's not cutting out stuff. You listen to some of his beginning music, and he would never do that. He was just your simple, you know, three verses and move on type of guy. But now, man, he's giving us so much substance. I like it a lot. It was an okay song. This is not my favorite of the three, the least favorite one that I've heard so far. And it has nothing to do with the lyrics or anything. It's just, you know, the beat, you know, something. It's not something that's it caught me and something that I'd go straight to on a track. You know, like certain songs, you know, there's certain songs we have where when we put that album in, we go straight to that song. And that definitely isn't one of them. Not that it's bad by any means, you know. It wasn't bad because I liked what he was saying and I liked the flow and, you know. But you understand what I'm saying. So there you go, guys. This is You're Gonna Learn. You know, featuring Royce da 5'9 in White Gold. And somebody please educate me. And when I say educate me, come at me like an adult, please. And just, was that Royce da 5'9 rapping? Or was that White Gold? Did they both rap there and I just missed one? You know, or was one of them doing the hook? You know, one of them was doing the hook? Let me know. I'm really curious to know. I'm a curious guy, you know. And I like to learn new stuff all the time. So, really cool. So thank you so much, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you're enjoying this album, because so far it's nice, you know. And you know, it sucks I'm getting a song a day, from this album, because I'm not gonna cheat my reaction or cheat y'all and listen to the album, you know, and then go back. Because if I listen to it, I'm just not gonna do a reaction to it. That's just how it is. That's why you guys haven't seen me do reactions to a lot of NF stuff. I've done a few, but not a lot, because you know I go out and listen to it. So there you go. Thank you guys for all your comments and suggestions. Thank you guys out there in the Patreon world. Guys, check out Patreon. I've got some exciting stuff coming starting February 1st. So check it out. You know, I've got some cool things that are going to happen there. And all Patreon does is just helps me make this channel better. Because eventually, we're moving into movie reviews and stuff. And I think that's going to be so much fun talking about some really bad movies. Like, you know, Battlefield Earth. You know, that's such a bad movie. Maybe Batman and Robin. Oh, what a terrible movie. But then we can talk about some movies that maybe are terrible movies, but at the same time, they've grabbed, like, cult status, you know? Like movies like say, Biodome. You know, like, Biodome was terrible. But, I mean, it's got a little cult following. And I'm not just saying just that one, but there's a lot of movies that we can think about. Give me some suggestions in the comments that movies you think are terrible, but you just can't help watching them. You know what I mean? They're so bad, but you still enjoy watching them, if you get what I'm saying. So thank you so much, guys. Again, I'm Humbled Mumbles. I really appreciate you guys listening to me rant. And until next time, have a beautiful day. Goodbye.